Hi all, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Ronke and I love to talk about travel, career, and lifestyle. Just want to start off by saying happy new year to everyone. I'm so excited to be in the year 2022, the year of our Lord 2022, hallelujah. And I'm just really looking forward to like all this year has to offer. I want to first start by just thanking every single person who subscribed to my channel in 2021 and even in previous years. Y'all, I know I have been kind of here, kind of not there, but I appreciate you all for believing in me, believing in this channel, and for just giving me the opportunity to, you know, come out here and do what I like to do. So I just want to thank you all, and I am believing that we'll have a phenomenal year this year on this channel. Through content and just really building this channel up. So thank you all so much, and I look forward to all the 2022 subscribers. Hey! All right, so without further ado, I initially was planning to upload a video last week, but I just wasn't feeling like it, to be honest. And what I instead did is I spent the last week thereabout just building myself and really trying to get a word spiritually, if that makes sense. So within the last week, I didn't do anything video related. I really was just watching this conference called WAFBEC, and I feel so much better for having done that, because I think it kind of shifted my mindset on some certain things, which I feel will ultimately improve the quality of the content that I bring forth for you all. So I missed you all last week. I hope y'all missed me last week. But I took last week off so I can come back better. So on the heels of a conference or a program like WAFBEC, for me, you know, I'd already kind of planned what my first video of the year was gonna be, and it is all the more meaningful to me now, especially after going through that conference. And you know, in today's video, I wanna talk about purpose. Purpose and self. Right? I think for a lot of us, we find ourselves in a position whereby we oftentimes don't actually put our purpose first, right? We don't put ourselves first. We don't put our purpose first because of a variety of other things. And we end up suffering for it in the long run because you're not fulfilling your purpose, or you're not fulfilling the things that you ought to be fulfilling as an individual. The truth is, we cannot have it all or be it all the time. There are some seasons in life where you need to withdraw and just build yourself. And then there are some other seasons where you might need help, right? You might be the person in need of encouragement versus the person always encouraging. And for me, I think that's just one thing that through last year was coming across me very well. But even through WAFBEC has just become so more pressing to me that we really have to focus on our purpose and living that out. And the truth is, choosing your purpose first does, to some degree, mean choosing yourself first. Now, I'm saying to some degree because this is not a license to then be selfish and not genuinely care about the good of others. But this does mean that you have to have boundaries to understand what you can do, what is reasonable for you to do, versus what is even outside of your own wheelhouse that you're bending yourself backwards to do, all for the sake of, I help such and such person. Putting yourself and your purpose first, for me, one of the key things is that that means that you are so more in tune with yourself to understand when even things that from a regular lens look good, you're so quick to understand when those things start to become detrimental to you. For example, let's say you have a friend who is maybe looking for a new job, and you are helping your friend to look for a new job, but to the extent that you start suffering at your job, even though you know of another resource that could help your friend, that to me right there is not putting your purpose first. What you should do is tell your friend, let me pass you on to this resource so they can help you out better than I could while I still fulfill my purpose. And the thing you'll find with it is that in some instances, when you then communicate with people to let them know I need X amount of my time back, or this is how much I can give you, you may find that some people don't take it so well. And that's okay. Because if you truly feel that whatever it is either is not aligned with your purpose or is not a high priority in fulfilling your purpose, they're gonna be all right. They don't have a choice but to be okay. So you really have to do what's right for yourself. I would say that this was something that just came to me last year when I was reading the story of the Good Samaritan. The way the story goes is that the Good Samaritan was just one of the, what, maybe four or five people who passed by this guy who was badly beaten up. The Good Samaritan was the last one, and he's the only one that also helps this man. He helps this man go to an inn and takes him to the innkeeper and is essentially like, here's some money to take care of him, but I'll be back in a couple of days to pay the balance. Just do whatever you need to do to get him back to health. And so the Good Samaritan goes off. This is somebody who could stop to help while they were on their way to their purpose, but they didn't lose sight of what they were still doing. I'm sure the Good Samaritan took this man to the innkeeper because he knew that he probably had the medical or whatever background that was necessary to take care of this man. You know, being purpose first for me is also about filling yourself up before you try to fill others up. So, you know, people always say you can't give what you don't have, and that's the truth. It's really hard for you to be in a season where maybe you're discouraged or you're down, and then you got to be somebody else's encouragement. Like, that's extremely hard, you guys. And yes, there are some times and in some circumstances where God is giving you the grace to do it, but it genuinely can be a hard thing to do. And so for me, I feel that if you realize that I'm literally at like 0%, like I'm in, like I don't have anything to give anyone, you take some time for yourself. You know, feel free to take a step back. And you sometimes you don't have to explicitly say it, although if you are doing, like, let's say you're actively volunteering with like a girls and boys club, I would probably tell them I need like a sabbatical, I need a break, I need something. But you want to take that time so that you can build yourself back up. It is extremely hard for you to continue to give when there's nothing left. Like, just don't do that to yourself. And even on the heels of that, you know, putting your purpose first and choosing yourself first, to me, it means that you take a break when you need it. You know, I think a lot of times, and actually let me correct that. It's not even that you take a break when you need it. It's you take a break kind of before you need it, right? Because I feel that so often people define when they need it as when they already are breaking apart. We have to get out of the habit of waiting until we are like broken down or past our breaking point to address issues that we might be having. Please, in this year, do that for yourself. Take some time and be able to start like identifying when you're getting close to your stressors, right? They always say it's the straw that broke the camel's back. It doesn't mean that straw in general breaks the camel's back. What it means is that there was one particular piece of straw that was like, all right, well, that's too much for me, I can't do it. But more than likely, you knew getting up to it that this is getting a lot for me. So when you feel like things are getting too much for you, sometimes you will need to take a step back and just kind of relax and assess where you are and see if you're in need of that break. And then finally for me, you know, putting your purpose first. I remember I talked about this in my wrap up end of the year video about how I'm not setting no new goals and yada, yada, yada. And I mean, for the most part, that is true. I didn't necessarily set new goals for the sake of having goals, new goals for the year. I mean, I have just general life goals that I feel that I'm working on. But it's important when you are putting your purpose first that you choose goals or that you choose things that matter most to you. Sometimes there can be pressure to do certain things, or like, let's say at work, someone finds out that you are so good in graphics, but you don't like graphics, it's not really your calling, but you just happen to be good at it. And someone figures out that you're so good at it, and they're like, oh, go help our graphics team on some special project. And you end up doing that, and you're giving so much time to that, that the things that are actually of your interest, things that are actually within your purpose sphere, you're not giving time, effort, whatever it is, into them. I just really believe going into this year that it's so important for all of us to just be conscious about that, because there's so many things always pulling for your attention. There's so many things that you could be doing, but you have to just wisely choose what's most important to you and go from there. I hope you all enjoy some of the honest conversation that I'm having with you all today. But as I said, this is something that for me, I've been learning and has been super key for how I want to live my life in general moving forward, whether it's at the beginning of a new year, the beginning of a new day, anything. That's all I have for you today. Please let me know in the comments how you plan to be purposeful to put your purpose first. As always, please make sure to like this video, share it with others, and make sure that you subscribe to my channel for more travel, career, and lifestyle content.